Have you wanted to play the latest desktop PC game titles with the comfort of your living room couch? But it may not be very convenient to move the PC every time you just want to play a game. Well, actually, today you have two main options for solving this problem: Steam Remote Play and Nvidia GameStream. And in this video, we will find out which technology is the best. First of all, let's talk about the specifications of these two technologies. Nvidia GameStream supports streaming at 60 frames per second at resolutions up to 4K with HDR enabled. Also, Nvidia GameStream uses hardware video encoders built into Nvidia graphics cards to provide the most performant screen recording at lowest latency possible. You may think that you will need to buy expensive Nvidia Shield device for being able to cast games with Nvidia GameStream. Well, actually no. With the help of open source software called Moonlight, you will be able to play from nearly any platform that you can imagine. Also, Moonlight supports streaming at 4K resolution with 120 fps and vertical synchronization enabled. And with the help of Moonlight Internet Hosting Tool, you will be able to play games from your home desktop computer from everywhere in the world with good internet connection. But the main drawback of Nvidia GameStream, it is requirement of Nvidia graphics card at the host. Steam Remote Play supports only 60 fps at 4K resolution. Steam Remote Play is supported on all platforms that can run the Steam client. Also, with the application called Steam Link, you can cast games to Android, iOS, and Raspberry Pi. Steam Remote Play doesn't require an Nvidia graphics card. And also, Steam Remote Play supports play over internet, but only for supported titles. And the last, Steam Remote Play provides ability to play games with only local multiplayer with friends over internet. It's like football simulators or other games. Now let's compare the practical differences between these two technologies. For the setup, I use the following scheme. Server is running on the desktop PC with Windows 10. This PC is connected through Ethernet cable to the router. The client is running on the laptop with Arch Linux. This laptop is connected over Wi-Fi 5 GHz or over Ethernet. And we will compare the performance of these two connections. For the Steam Remote Play, I use the following config. Bandwidth is limited automatically, resolution is limited to 1080p, and client profile, network profile is set to fast. For the Moonlight over Wi-Fi test, I will use 1080p resolution with 60 fps, vertical synchronization enabled. Video bandwidth will be limited to 10 megabits per second. Here I run Counter-Strike Global Offensive over Steam Remote Play over Wi-Fi. As you can see on the lower left corner, the screen resolution is 1080p. Encoder that's used on the server is NVNC H264. It is the same hardware video encoder that used by Nvidia GameStream. Also, for decoder on the client, it uses software video decoder. It is a lot slower, but it's fine for this situation. The pings for input 15 milliseconds and for the display it's 30 milliseconds because of software decoding. Also, as you can see, when I move or rotate the character, the picture quality drops dramatically because of the reason that the more you change the picture, the more bandwidth is required to transfer this picture from one device to another. So, as you can see on the down right corner, on rotations or movement, pings increase to 100 milliseconds. Now I run Counter-Strike Global Offensive over Moonlight over Wi-Fi. As you can see on the movement or rotation of the game character, there are a lot less compression artifacts compared to the Steam Remote Play. Also, overall responsiveness of the game is much better, but contrary to the Steam Remote Play, when connection quality drops, the Moonlight drops some frames instead of compressing on the higher rate. Now we will test Steam Remote Play Counter-Strike Global Offensive over Ethernet connection. As you can see, pings stayed the same to the Wi-Fi connection, it's near 30 milliseconds, but picture quality is much better, and estimated bandwidth is 2 times better. There are no compression artifacts visible on the movement or rotation of the game character. Now let's test Counter-Strike Global Offensive over Moonlight with Ethernet connection. There are also no compression artifacts like in Steam Remote Play, and no frames dropped as you can see. Now let's try to play the more demanding game Kingdom Come Deliverance with Steam Remote Play over Ethernet connection. As you can see, the estimated bandwidth is 9 megabits per second, but the picture quality is not very good for 1080p. It looks like 720p, but resize it to 1080p when you move the character or ride the horse. Also, as you can see, the game is quite playable because I can even fight successfully with guards. But the nature, grass and trees are compressed pretty heavily, so the picture looks smoothed and not represent the real picture on the monitor of the desktop PC. Now we will try to play the over Moonlight, the Kingdom Come Deliverance with 10 megabits per second bandwidth limit. As you can see, when horse rides fast, there are visible JPEG compression artifacts everywhere, and picture looks smoothed. But the game itself is quite playable, the same as over the Steam Remote Play. As you can see, I successfully killed the guard and some peasant guy, but this another guard is harder because he has shield. But with tricky kick I successfully can kill this guy also. Now let's try to play Kingdom Come Deliverance over Moonlight with 40 megabits per second bandwidth limit. As you can see, there are no JPEG compression artifacts visible on the screen. And also overall game responsiveness hasn't changed. But these two guards will probably kill me because There are two of them in the quite small space. I had no chances. Also, if you look on the trees, grass and flowers, there are no blur or compression artifacts visible on the screen. The game looks the same as on the desktop PC monitor. Well, maybe not the same, but the difference is not distinguishable by the eye. Here is the example setup of Steam Link using Raspberry Pi. The Raspberry Pi is connected to the TV, and I use keyboard and mouse connected to the Raspberry Pi. The Raspberry Pi itself is connected to the router over Ethernet cable. Also, Raspberry uses hardware video decoder, and pings are for streaming. It's near 5 milliseconds, for display it's near 13-15 milliseconds, and 1 millisecond ping for connection. So, for conclusion, I can say that both technologies have nearly the same specifications and slightly different limitations for streaming over internet. The only difference is that Moonlight performs better over pure and stable internet connection, providing more clear picture without square compression artifacts on every movement. But on the stable network connection over Ethernet, Moonlight and Steam Link provide nearly the same image quality and responsiveness of the game. By the way, with use of Steam client on the Arch Linux, time by time I had lots of freezes and the setup was completely unplayable. But for the video I catched the Steam Remote Play performance compared to the other platforms. And if you have different experience with Steam Remote Play on Arch Linux, please do not hesitate to tell me in the comment section below. For choosing the better technology in your case, the general rule of thumb would be: if you plan to play over Wi-Fi, use Moonlight. If you don't have Nvidia graphics card, use Steam Remote Play. Thank you for watching till this moment. If you liked this video, you may also find interesting my video about GPU pass-through over link here. Also, subscribe for my channel to don't miss my future video. Thanks for watching, bye.